Hi everybody, Joe here. Thanks for tuning in. This will be the first of a short series of videos that will explore my interpretation of something that's become quite popular with Latin percussionists, which is putting together all of the instruments for one player. I use this for small ensembles, combos, duos, trios, both in Latin styles and in calypso, pan, that type of stuff. And it works pretty well. So this video specifically is going to look at this guy here, the LP Fusheki Maraca pedal, and some of the modifications that I've done to it to suit my own needs. As you can see here, the pedal comes with this brace. That way you can get a backward and forward motion on the maraca itself as you use it. So downbeats look like this. Eighth notes look like this. Which is very useful. For me, though, I want to try and get some of the natural swish that occurs in the maracas as if you were playing it with your hands, which means that the maraca, when it hits this backstop, it jolts the beads in the maraca and doesn't let them move naturally. So after some tinkering around, I found that if I remove this back piece entirely, I can get some of that natural movement from the beads. So I just got rid of this and then practiced this technique. It takes some getting used to in your foot to figure out exactly how that feels in the pedal. But if you adjust your tension on the pedal correctly, it becomes fairly natural feeling and you can find that swish. One thing about this is you're limited in tempo. You can't go super fast or super slow just because of the way that this is set up. But it's still rather useful for most tempos in salsa and in calypso. For really slow stuff, you can go back to just downbeats if you need to. So I played this in bands for a while, got used to it, figured out how to incorporate it, set this on autopilot with that feel after I had practiced it for a while. And then I came to realize that this rubber doesn't have to be there necessarily, and it does give you a little bit of a low thump that you might be able to hear through the camera when I play it. So I decided to go back to the drawing board a little bit and found this next rendition of my experiments worked really well. So I'm gonna get rid of this guy and show you this guy. I figured if you don't need that rubber necessarily, you just need something to hit, why not use a cowbell? You want the cowbell there for the downbeats anyways in the music more often than not. So I tried that and came up with this. That's pretty awesome to me, at least. I looked at everything, I've used it for a little while, haven't found any damage on the maraca, haven't found any damage on the joint. You might have noticed on the last one there was some tape. The first maraca that I had broke there and I had to have LP send me this new one. The tape works for demonstration, but I wouldn't trust it to perform with it. Obviously no damage to the bell, so this seems to be working. You don't want to play it super loud. I wouldn't really want to shred on this thing for fear of hurting it. But this is for a one-man operation. This is not to play with a full salsa band. This is if you're accompanying a pan player or a guitarist or something like that. So it doesn't need to be very loud. You just want those tones present in your music. So again, it sounds like this. It does take some time to practice that. Again, set your tension because the maraca is much heavier than a beater, and you'll get used to finding where that's supposed to be to get that swish in the maraca. Now, say you were playing some down music that you didn't want the cowbell in, and I had to think about this for a little while. how was I going to do that? Did I want to have two pedals, one here that was just a maraca, and one here that was maraca and bell? And after some thinking about it, I realized low-tech is often the best way to go. So out comes the towel, and it works just like the rubber stopper. You might get a little bit of low end, but you don't hear the bell. So that seems to work pretty well. Yeah, you have to reach down and grab it if you're going from a low section to a high section, but barring anything else that I could come up with, that seems to work. So really quick, I'll put that in context in the one-man band, and for the next video, we'll take a look at the whole setup, putting this into context. Stay safe, stay healthy, practice weird stuff. We'll see you next time.